Hey guys, Stephanie with AmericanMuscle.com here with a review of the GT350 Voodoo intake manifold for the 2015 and newer GT and GT350 Mustang. The Ford Performance GT350 Voodoo intake manifold is going to be a great option for the S550 owners out there that are looking to improve top-end, high RPM power with little to no low-end torque loss, either on a stock setup or on a powerful naturally aspirated or even boosted setup. This manifold will need to be used in conjunction with the Ford Performance GT350 Throttle Body, and those two mods are complementary upgrades that'll set you on the path to squeezing the most performance out of the Coyote. This manifold is original equipment on the GT350 and the GT350R, which are race-inspired. This manifold, paired with the GT350 throttle body, will improve airflow in the top end, which is going to equate to better performance at higher RPMs, giving you those top end gains. The intake is tuned for 7,500 RPM peak power, and it'll fit the S550 GT with the stock fuel rails. Now, it's strongly recommended to pair this intake and the throttle body with a tune, and let's face it, if you're shopping for an intake mani and a throttle body, you're looking for performance, and how are you going to get the most performance possible without a tune? Ourselves ended up installing the intake manifold and throttle body and uploading a tune, and here are the results. The stock baseline run showed us 390 horsepower and 366 foot-pounds of torque. After the manifold, throttle body, and tune, we saw 410 horsepower and 362 foot-pounds of torque. That makes for peak gains of 20 horsepower and a 4 foot-pound loss of torque. Your curve gains are 20 horsepower and 18 foot-pounds of torque. So you do see a very minor loss of torque in the top end, but 4 foot-pounds isn't something that you're gonna notice. I'm not really all that surprised about the torque loss here because this car is stock other than the manifold and throttle body. A modification like this one does tend to do better when you pair it with other mods like exhaust or long tubes, a cold air intake, and other bolt-ons. Your curve gains here are good. Your curve gains are what you're gonna notice, not so much your peak gain. The graph shows you both low-end and top-end gains with this manifold and throttle body, which is nice to see. This manifold is designed more for top-end gains. It really opens up airflow in those higher RPMs, and that's where this thing likes to perform. Let's talk about the actual construction of the manifold some. It's made from a lightweight composite material, and it comes assembled with the charge motion control valves that are pre-installed. This is done so that the manifold will keep the stock-like driving characteristics while still delivering on power. The composite material is going to function well both on an NA setup as well as under boost, which is a nice feature because you don't have to avoid this manifold if you're looking to do a forced induction build. And a little bit more general info here. Of course, this is going to fit the S550 GT350 and the GT350R as well as the GT. But it's not going to fit under the stock strut tire brace on the GT. You're either going to need a taller brace that the manifold will fit under, or you're looking at losing the brace altogether. As far as price, this is a pretty serious mod, and so it's going to have a pretty serious price tag that comes along with it. Power isn't usually cheap, at least good sustainable power anyway, so you're looking at spending a little over $1,000 for this manifold. The 87mm throttle body that you'll need to run with the manifold costs just under $200. Now keep in mind that these are Ford Performance products, so you've got the comfort of the Ford quality and fitment and the know-how back in the design of this manifold, so the install here really isn't difficult. The manifold is obviously easy to access, and I wouldn't say that this takes a ton of know-how to do, but you should have a little bit of experience before you just try to tackle this yourself. You might need to make a few minor modifications to some vacuum lines for proper install, and it'll take about 2 hours of your time. I'm gonna call it a 2 out of 3 on the difficulty meter. You need a few different sockets, a fuel line disconnect tool, and a torque wrench as well. Giving a general overview of the install, you're looking at having to depressurize the fuel system so you can remove the fuel rails and disconnect all electrical and vacuum connections in the manifold. This means the TPS, the MAF, the ETC, and the ejectors, and anything going to the intake. The fuel rails will need to be removed so you can pull the manifold, and following the proper sequence would be a good idea here when you're unbolting the manifold. After you get all of the stock components uninstalled, then it's just a matter of installing the new manifold after you clean up the block. You want a nice clean surface for your gaskets. When you do go to bolt down your new manifold, follow the bolt sequence here and torque these bad boys down to spec so you don't have any issues. You install all of the other items, including the fuel line crossover and all of your electrical and vacuum connections. Wrapping things up here with the Ford Performance GT350 Voodoo intake manifold, this manifold will fit the 2015 and newer S550 GT, GT350, and the GT350R, and you can check it out more online right here at AmericanMuscle.com.